Hello everybody, welcome to Deluxe Collectibles, and today we're going to be discussing some really interesting information from Tommy Andreasen over on Twitter, of course the creator of Ninjago, and he actually hosted a Q&A, which was super cool of him to do that, and he gave some really interesting answers to some super great questions, and I wanted to discuss a couple of them in separate videos, so I'm sure you're going to see a few of these on the channel over a little while, but I want to lay down some of the ground rules that he gave for this Q&A here, and those were that there would be no requests for spoilers or future stuff, and that any speculative information he may answer, but the answer would not be considered canon, basically. So I found that really interesting. Of course, it's just so that, of course, you're not going to take this as like a canon thing. It's not confirmed to be happening, and it's also not denied to be happening, so just take it with a grain of salt. But still, I thought it was kind of a cool thing to sort of have a discussion off of. So here is the question that was asked, and it was, what do you think of Kai and Nia's relationship? And then Tommy answered with, I think Kai grieves Nia and isn't handling it very constructively. And I thought this was really interesting because I've done several videos at this point talking about who is going to be the main ninja for the next season, what's going to be happening in that season, and what would kind of be some points to sort of prove who is going to be that main ninja. And this kind of fuels a bit of the fire on possibly Kai being the main ninja for the next season, because it definitely sounds like we're going to get to see how he's going to be dealing with Nia, of course, leaving the team and kind of just being gone sort of permanently, at least for a point of time. I suppose it's not going to be, I don't believe, at least permanent, but for a period of time, she's off of the team, of course, as she did sacrifice herself in a sort of way at the end of Seabound. So it'll be interesting to kind of see how Kai does end up dealing with that. And it doesn't sound like it's going to be very constructively, and it sounds like he's really going to be grieving her. And this is what I've kind of talked about in some other videos, is that I feel like it's going to be two sides of a coin, and it's going to be that Kai's not dealing with this too well. He's trying to go out on his own possibly and kind of try to find her with maybe some ways that the ninja would not normally go about things. And then I think Jay is going to at least try to handle it a bit more constructively, try to keep the team together and try to work together to be able to get Nia back. But I feel like Kai, being the sort of hothead of the group, is kind of going to go off on his own, and that would allow for some great single character development for him, maybe even running into some other characters as well, or some new people also, maybe even becoming manipulated by some of them as well, kind of letting the anger get the best of him. Of course, we've kind of seen a little bit of that in the past, where Kai kind of lets loose a little bit, and maybe that could be something that could be a bit of a downfall for him in this new sort of arc for Ninjago. But I think this is really interesting. I'm glad to hear that he is going to be dealing with this. This is something that I really want to see the ninja processing. Of course, I didn't think it would be something that they would just skip over, but there have been some big things that have happened in Ninjago, and then I feel like we kind of just skip over like the end thing, the sort of like just what's happening afterwards. I feel like we don't deal with it sometimes. Something like, for instance, let's say like Zane becoming the Ice Emperor and causing so much like disdain in that separate realm, and then just kind of being turned back, and then us not really getting to see him deal with the ramifications of that, even just for himself. And I'm not sure why we didn't wind up seeing that. Of course, it could just happen because of course, how you have to keep the story moving. I understand that we can't dedicate a ton of time to him dealing with that. Of course, I don't think we're going to have a Ninjago episode where he goes and gets counseling for that, really any of the ninja, because of course they've been through some traumatic things. And I actually did see some questions, I won't like name them specifically or read them out specifically, but I saw kind of asking about how are the ninjas sort of dealing with this, are they going to get counseling? And of course, they're not going to actually have that happen, but they're going to deal with it in different ways, I would assume, in the future seasons. And I think that would be really interesting to sort of see, because we've had darker moments in Ninjago and sort of seen the group split up previously, kind of dealing with things like specifically, let's say, like at the end of season 3, Zane, of course, like dying basically, but then of course returning in the next season. And I think it'll be a similar sort of thing for this instance as well. And I think that's just really interesting, and I'm glad that Tommy acknowledged it here in a tweet. Once again, take with a grain of salt. Of course, we don't know how this is going to go about in the new season of Ninjago, so don't read into it too much, even though that's kind of what I'm doing in this video, but never mind that. I still think it's kind of an interesting topic to discuss, and let me know your thoughts on it down below in the comment section. I'm really curious to hear what are your sort of theories on how Kai is going to go about grieving Nia, and how is he going to act after this happening. So let me know all of your thoughts down below, and if you did enjoy this video, it would be highly appreciated if you could leave a like. Also subscribe as well if you would like to check out some of my other content. That would be highly appreciated. So thank you so much. I will see you all next time, and always remember, keep on collecting.